Good to see you.
Hi, Stan, how are you?
Good.
Jack, here, nice to see you. Glad to see you, yes, sir.
Thank goodness, I haven't seen such nasty, nasty things about managers.
Hi, how are you? Very nice to see you, just fine, thank you.
Nice to see you.
Glad to see you.
Anywhere?
Hi, how are you? Could we have some of you go to the other side of the president, do one group picture? No, no.
I got it right here, I hope I can see over these two. Close to the close.
Got everybody set? Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, listen, I also know America's about 98% elections also.
But it's a lot different than.
It is somewhat, because since every year, I'm going to make a speech and say, right?
Lot of people down to earth. It really is a earth.
Yep. I bet he does take the pigs to the beach.
He probably does.
Yes.
Yes, hi, how are you?
Congratulations.
Yes.
Great win, great win.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad.
No, sir.
And I appreciated your telephone calls. That was really nice. Matter of fact, we just cleared the cobwebs out of our hair.
Now, you're just here in time for us to tell you about a few of the things that you were talking about. I really do. Like the nuclear freeze resolution.
It's coming up about that.
I understand. Yeah, you've come right, ready to get right into it.
Already I find out that I moved up, yes.
What are your laws? Do you have 90 days or something, and then it's back as you think?
I think it's something, I'm trying to remember, there's something about it that's within a certain period of time of the election, but I think it wouldn't be within that period.
The governor calls it.
The governor does call, we were asking about that today. The governor does call.
He calls it, but does he have to wait 90 days or not?
No, I think he can call it immediately.
We have something in California we passed in which if it's close enough to the next regular election, you don't have to call the special. But this being a year and a half away or more, no, that's not the thing.
Triad group.
Yeah, this is
Missile Mom.
And there are two kids with him that play hockey and soccer. It's a private group. Forgetting to get to the build of the stadium.
Working.
Yes.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you today?
Hi.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You looking wonderful.
Hey, Tom. How are you?
Hi, George.
Good to see you. How are you doing?
Sandy Meyer.
It's really exciting.
How are you?
Yeah.
Mr. President. Which is hockey and which is soccer?
Soccer.
Soccer? And you're hockey?
Well, hello there. And Sheila Cronin, Mr. President.
Hello.
She's a donor. She's a donor.
Let's get our picture, right?
Yeah, let's have a group.
Sammy's in charge. Sheila's.
Take folks, come on.
Set it up.
Hold on. Triad.
Yours is bigger than mine, Mr. President.
Yeah.
I wonder why.
The right size.
This is quite a voluntary project. This is the reason we're doing it, Mr. President. They're going to raise all the money for this huge sports dome from local funds. No federal money. Now, if you want to give us some federal money,
I wouldn't want to break the purity.
Come on,
no,
in.
That's fine. That's great. Thank you so much.
Oh, did you have in mind? And he said hockey. And Rodney said, we thought of that once, but then he said, the father who was the president of the university said no. Notre Dame would never sponsor a game to put a club in the hands of an Irishman. Three times today, with you see, there's been some changes.
The business guy?
Yeah. It's just a group of his businessmen.
Pretty outside.
When is
Is she coming?
No, not that.
You, Bill Boner?
Yes.
President.
How are you?
Good to be with you, sir.
I appreciate it.
Oh, Bill, how are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
President.
This is Mike Rose from Nashville. Bush, nice to meet you. How are you?
See you, sir.
Nice to see you.
This is Bill Freeman.
How are you?
Nice to see you, welcome.
And this is Cal.
How are you?
Fine, nice to see you.
And this is Jimmy Webb.
President, real pleasure.
And this is Tom Cone.
Hi, glad to see you.
Glad to meet you. I want you to know that I told these guys one thing, and that was that most of these, I'm sure, if not all, are your supporters. And I just didn't want you converting them along. Well, as I told David Wright, you never say yes and you never say no. You always want to negotiate. We appreciate your letting us come in and be with you.
Well,
these guys are all from Nashville, Tennessee, and we're honored that you would let us do it in both of you. I see, I'm worried about how you run the operation here because I see the vice president down in the gym playing a little racquetball down there. Now, I'm sure that's customer ball because he never wins. I don't know if it's his ability or he's just letting Sonny Montgomery and those guys beat
him. I beat Montgomery yesterday. I got to I think there's something to be said for exercise and tact.
That's right. He does that. Well, we appreciate you.
We're indebted to Nashville for Bill Brock, and we're indebted just several weeks ago when the 25th anniversary of the Country Music Association is held here at Constitutional Hall. We had a great evening. Jordan Barber on one side of the hall, and we were on the other, and it was all a lot of fun.
Please come back and visit us. Please come back to Nashville.
You
don't have more hospitality.
The Beach Boys played that.
Just kind of,
I went there thanking somebody for all that went on, really, though, because I have $100 worth of Fourth of July is going to be very remunerative for them.
They said they had an invitation from every state.
That's correct. That country western thing's on this week, Mr. President.
That thing that you just referred to?
I think it's like tomorrow or the next day. Wednesday.
Thank you. We won't keep
you.
Thank
you.
We appreciate
you.
Really appreciate
you.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
He's 19 years old.
He's really accomplished a great deal. Read his
records.
Is he the next group?
Is anybody here?
I'm afraid we're
no. This is the Jewish.
Did he appear over here at that first when we were first in office?
There was something out in
out
the
at
Rose
the
Garden.
Ford. No, but at the Ford Theater.
Yeah.
She was kind of stand up talking.
Country thing. Music.
No, it was something, but it was the thing. I thought you and Nancy went to it. Sat next to Howard Baker down.
Yes.
In the front row.
Yeah, we were.
Well,
yeah.
This woman had a. Kind of like an MC role that you had to retake it and everything. But anyway, she was.
Benefit of Ford Theater.
Okay, no, there was another gal that was doing that too. Linda.
I'm going to ask this woman.
Evans. Not Linda Evans. Wonder Woman.
But the
Linda Carter. Woman. Linda Carter was.
Jack Klugman, I think, was with her for Victoria.
I think this
was
one.
Okay, that was at the Kennedy Center, though, wasn't it?
Ford.
I've got my
bell ringer of Notre Dame Cathedral. And he wanted to take a vacation, advertise for somebody to come in and ring the bells in the tower while he was gone. So a big able-bodied fellow reported, and he said, well, now this is the way you do it. He said, you take this bell, and you swing it over, and then as it comes back, you let it hit you in the head, and that makes the most beautiful sound. And the guy said, he said, really? I've been doing it for years. He said, it's all right. So the guy gets down there, and just as the bell comes back, he looks up, hits him right in the face, off he goes, and down splat on the street. Crowd begins to gather. Quasimodo hurries down. He gets there, and a policeman says to him, do you know who he is? And he said, no, but his face sure rings a bell. That's the story. up comes one of our aide with this sequel. The fella had a twin brother. And the twin brother comes and applies for the job in the same routine and everything, and can't keep his baby. Off and down he goes. Quasimodo rings down again. They ask him if he knows his name, and he says no, but he's a dead ringer
for his brother.
Comes back. You heard, maybe they haven't heard. He comes back, and they so grateful, so the chiefs get around. He says, what can I do? I'm the first Indian to have ever received an electrical engineering degree. And they said, well, that's wonderful. But he said, for years, the people in this reservation have had to go to the outbuildings at night in total darkness. Can you put the wiring in there? And the guy did. Wired it all up, and thus he became the first Indian to wire ahead for a reservation.
That's pretty good.
We've got to stop meeting like this.
Hello, President. How are you, sir?
Good.
Very nice to see you.
How are you?
How are you? This is Ellen Levin, my staff.
Hello, Arlen.
President.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Is this the whole delegation?
Well, no.
Hi, Ellen.
We have some more.
Oh, here they come. Jack Macon.
This is Mrs. Muriel Berman.
Hello there.
The lady who is in charge of this.
Very nice.
Yes, nice to meet you. Governor Penn's only signed it like one word. Yeah, that's why I have to use two.
Thank you. I'll give this one to my wife, Mr. President.
All right. Where, Mr. Wiswell?
He's right here. Right here. Give it to John.
Oh, there. John.
Mr. President,
John.
We have a thing for you on behalf of the Arthritis Foundation.
Well,
it's walking pens.
Thank you very much. Do you want the boxes with them? Would you like to have the boxes? All right.
John and I would like to present you with this. A clock we think says exactly, well, the message behind it.
Yes.
Can you cross this way, sir?
Thank you very much.
We'd like to see the pocket you're going to put it in. The pocket you're going to put it in.
And then hang me on the wall. Well, that's, all right.
Well, we appreciate your interest, Mr. President. This will help them with private contributions to bring attention to it. And one out of every six people have some arthritis in one form or another, so it's.
Senator, it's interesting that you have four types represented right here. And you have your wife, John, Victoria's mother, and Peter in the back. There's four different types of arthritis represented right here today.
One thing we'd like to stress is that although a lot of older people develop it as they grow older, that, you know, the stiffness of rheumatism, we want to stress the fact that it's a major crippling disease, as in my case, that takes people's years. They have to fight their whole life just to, you know, get on crutches or something like that. And it's not just the minor aches and pains. People advertise on the aspirin commercials.
I know. I know.
That's
one of the most unforgettable men I've ever met in my life. Very much a part of my life. And I got out of college in 1932 and started looking for work in the depths of the Great Depression, and I decided radio was where I wanted to be. And finally, after hitchhiking around the country and being turned down many times, WOC Davenport and the program director, Peter MacArthur, who had come to this country with that great Scottish vaudevillian, then he stayed and became the program director. Mm. And that was his problem. And we were together for years till he was one of the. Anyone who had troubles sought him out. And somehow he could always make you feel better. He was a great man. But I know what you've done too.
Well, I've tried.
Yes, you
have. What you can do is you have to fight the best you can against it. You have a lot of support from parents and doctors and people in the Arthritis Foundation who care about everybody. Because without their help, you couldn't do half as much as I've done. So.
Well, you represent a hope to a great many people. I know about you and what you do with this vehicle here, the joggers and all. I think it's great.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Right.
Can I ask to say you?
Mr. President.
Have you been? You are.
Very nice to meet you.
Thank you. Oh.
Good luck in 84.
Oh, that rest.
Well, that was a nice story.
That's terrific. Nice to see you all.
Thank you, sir. Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir. Sorry we didn't ask for you. Sorry we didn't ask for you. Try. I think we might have a little bit. We better go for it.
This is Paul.
Oh, hello there.
What's going to tell you? This is John the Second. This is Julie. This is Nancy Moore.
Hello.
And this is Nancy.
Hi, Mr. President. Thank you for having
me. Now, let's see. You're nice to take a picture with us. Let's see. Can we put put the girls on each side of you?
All right.
Julie? Nancy, won't come up here. Now, Nancy, why don't you go on the other side? I'll step over there if you want to.
All right.
Is that too wide?
That's fine, sir.
No, they've got rubber.
Smile.
Well,
that's quite a nice
thing. As fine as I've seen our children. They're really well awestruck.
What you want to tell them, brother? Then they're going to tell them anything?
Yeah.
Well, what?
You're all good person.
Hey, he said, you're a good person. What do you want to tell him? What do you want to tell him? Quick. She's modest. What do you want to tell him? Huh? Quick. Very excited. That's what you want to tell him, I think. She's in sixth grade. these two in the exception of gift of class out of Hickok.
You're doing a wonderful job, Mr. President.
Well, thank you very much.
Beautiful kids.
Thank you.
Come on, let's go.
No, no, wait one second here, because, of course, the one I don't understand how she's here is Nancy. I can understand you being able to get here, but I know all the things that she's doing now, politically, but for charities and so forth, and how'd you have the time to...
We wouldn't have missed it.
This is a jar with the presidential seal and my signature on it, and the jar is full of jelly beans.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're more than welcome.
Thank you.
You give it to Mama, that's enough. You're very kind, Mr. President.
Why,
thank you very much.
It's a pleasure to see you all. This is the first time I've ever really seen you and your family all together.
Thank you.
It's nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Bye, Mr. President.
Goodbye.
Bye.